Hi everyone, welcome back to Cody's Lab. So many of you may remember this.
Tune in next week when I go to the hospital and get a blood test to see how much mercury I have in my system.
It's been a little bit more than the week that I said, but I did hold true to my promise and I went to the hospital and I had my blood drawn and the sample sent off to a lab to measure the mercury and lead levels. It is now sometime after that and I finally have the results. You can see that my mercury level in my blood is not elevated. In fact, it's in the normal range, which means I do not have mercury poisoning at all. If we go look at the lead levels are a bit high, but still within the range that'd be considered normal. My blood only had about 6 micrograms of mercury per liter. So this means that whatever I'm doing, it's not resulting in me being poisoned by the heavy metals. It actually kind of surprised me how low the levels actually were, because I dip my hands in liquid mercury all the time. But after thinking about it a little bit, the results do sort of make sense. I don't actually dip my hand in mercury every day, and I actually don't eat a lot of tuna fish. In fact, I don't really even remember the last time I had a tuna fish sandwich. That means that my exposure to mercury is very low. And I do take some precautions when I'm working with mercury. You know, I always do it in a well-ventilated area. And when I'm working with mercury compounds, which actually can absorb through the skin, then I put on some gloves. Also, the test that was done would not actually reveal the amount of mercury that's like inside of my tissues, like my fat cells and muscle. Instead, it only detected what was in the intercellular space or the blood. But since that number still wasn't very high, we have no reason to believe that I have high levels anywhere in my body. I was actually really worried about the test results, because if the levels would have been up around, say, 50 micrograms per liter, then I would have had to change something, and I would have shown that I wasn't being very safe and actually getting poisoned. But since the levels were only 6 micrograms per liter, I am vindicated and shown that I actually have been fairly safe. Touching liquid mercury is probably not going to give you mercury poisoning, because mercury does not absorb through the skin very quickly, if at all. Mercury does evaporate, as all liquids do, but the amount that it evaporates is so little that I would have to hold a bowl of warmed mercury next to my face for hours before it would have any appreciable result. I'm still not saying to actually do that, but I'm saying that metallic mercury is not nearly as dangerous as people think. So I have here some nearly pure carbon. Now, nobody would complain about me eating this here, because carbon's a completely non-toxic material. It doesn't dissolve, and my body's made up of several percent carbon. But carbon, combined with nitrogen, makes cyanide. It's used by the Nazis to kill people during World War II. Metallic mercury is completely harmless until you've added something else to it, such as a nitrate group, which makes it soluble, and so it can actually get in and interact with your nervous system. Without that, mercury is just like any other metal. So, hope you guys enjoyed this little video. I'll see you next time.